Hello, welcome back. So I restarted my game because I played an episode in December, but then they released another update. So I think the game is in a very, very good position right now. I thought it was in December, but now it's actually amazing. I remember playing this game a couple of times and I was simply falling asleep because there was nothing to do. But now they modified everything, including the world generator. It feels like the maps are a little more balanced wise regarding the size and the enemies. Plus, you don't feel as bored because you can research certain items without building stuff, I don't know, just a much, much better gameplay loop. Also, we'll look at some of the newer things right now. Wait, let's pause the game, actually. You cannot. So, one of the newer additions, let's talk about the farming. As you can see, we need this land over here, I forgot what it's called. Let me see if I can... remember, I don't think it will show up. Oh yeah, arable land. To be honest, there's not a lot of it on the map. I think this was all of the land, arable land, which means basically means cultivatable land. And these are the tomatoes. As you can see, when they grow, they fall on the ground. These are the potatoes. I'm not sure. Yeah, well, I guess we can harvest them. Some of them will be harvestable, and I think some of them will fall simply down. Yeah, interesting. So as you can see, we have 4 new crops at least. So yeah, these are the cucumbers. So tomatoes, potatoes, cucumbers and carrots. And also I like the idea of these hanging gardens over here. Well, not exactly hanging gardens, but you get the idea. Also you get some new recipes with them. For example, I mean the fruits, well, the tomato is a fruit, the cucumber is the vegetable. They're not so bad themselves either. So before the nuts and berry salad would give you feeding 1 and healing 3%, but now you can actually make the tomato juice. I guess the downside is that it uses a bottle and water, but it actually gives you healing, which is great. Carrot juice gives the most healing. And then we also have the jam, which as you can see, it's a little bit comparable. So you have a lot more diversity in the food. Now, what about the other stuff? Well, I'm not sure if the huge plant was in the game beforehand. I don't remember finding it. Anyway, it's a huge plant that spits fireballs and it's also in the very dangerous category. Also, I think we have the Chronicle right now. I don't remember this being in the game either, or maybe I didn't pay a lot of attention to it. We have the notes. The bestiary, well, yeah, I think it was new, the plant, because I didn't get it before. Predatory bush. Also, let's speak a little bit about the armor. That was the armor update in December. They actually added a lot of stuff for the early game to make it less grindy. So right now we can do a bunch of stuff. For example, we have more armors available to us. The wooden, fortified wooden helmet. So 2 and 4. For example, this is very easy to build. I mean, you only need a little bit of iron and planks. Super easy to build, right? Then you have the wooden armor, which required a rope, which was one of the reasons I didn't build it. But after you upgraded the wooden armor, you can actually upgrade it a little further. So 4 to 6. Of course, the agility penalty is a bit too much. I don't know. It really depends on the map if you want to upgrade it or not. Another problem that I've seen is that I don't remember if you can unequip stuff from your little dwarves. So for example, if we give a helmet to someone, well, I guess the helmets are easy to unequip because, well, you can give them another. But I think the armors, you have to unequip them because it's the same problem with the backpacks. Well, okay, you can unequip the backpacks. Okay, no problem. For example, if you want to craft a better backpack, you have to unequip it. But there is a catch. There is actually a very big catch. You can only use the armored backpacks on the warriors. I don't think... Actually, I'm pretty sure the mages or the archers cannot use them. So let's craft one of these. As you can see, we have the steel, we have the nails. We're already missing the backpack. So let's try it like that. Like I said, the wool is limited. And now I actually have to wait for someone to craft it and then we'll see what... By the way, this is a mess. I actually messed up my housing situation quite a bit. So yeah, in response to that, I just decided to ignore it, and I'll just leave it as it is, because I'm very close to winning anyway. also wanted to... don't worry, we'll open the Pandora's box in a while. I just wanted to showcase some of the other stuff. So yes. See? It unequips your weapon. So yeah, that's going to be a rough decision. So I guess you'll need more warriors overall right now because they can carry more. In a way it makes sense, in a way it doesn't make sense, but actually I'm happy they balance the game out a little more. Wait a minute, I have an archer glove. Let's give it to an archer. Sadly, most of the archers are also smiths, so I should have thought about that a little better. Mage, well, he's a mage, you'll need the mage item. Also, the mage armor is quite fascinating, actually. So let me see. Oh, we have the steel armor already. Well, this will... Yeah. I guess you can still skip all of the wooden armor because you want to keep those strings for some other stuff. Let's make all of that. Let's make some of this. So yeah, the quick leather pack. I don't remember this one. Oh, this is actually useful. You can give it to a few dwarves and that will actually make it a lot more easy to research certain places. Yeah, as you can see, we also have the expert armor book and some other stuff to research stuff. And we can also kind of have this infinite research loop where you can actually increase the stats of your dwarves. So I guess that will be important for other stuff. Just a quick showcase of the other stuff I wanted to see and kind of make a note of. For example, more health. 5%, production speed 10%, mana recovery rate and skill level threshold. This will also be important probably later, but this is not a map that will need stuff like that. Is that full? Better make sure. Ah, don't worry, under attack it doesn't mean much. So the new mage armor is actually pretty interesting. It will use fabric. Fabric is not so hard to get, I mean, yeah, you need just the wool. Basically, the dyes are also pretty easy to make, so it's kind of like a lot of things, but they're easy to get. And to also give you mana. I'm not sure what this means. I never really paid attention to how much mana they use or how they use it, but I guess it makes sense in a way. So the mage cuirass offers 8 armor. As you can see, it also doesn't decrease the agility. I believe, I'm not sure if everyone can wear it or not. But anyway, it's comparable to leather armor, as you can see, it actually can be an alternative to leather armor if you really want some good armor that doesn't decrease your agility. Let me see... I assume everyone can use it, right? Yeah, so everyone can use it, that's a bit funny. Well, I guess the most useful it will be for the mages, but it's a bit funny because you can wear the lightest armor. So the armor situation has been vastly improved. Also, I think we can make the wooden boots right now. Yeah, simple wooden boots and then the advanced wooden boots which require the wooden boots. So I guess you can skip the iron boots so you'll save a lot of materials along the way. Let's just make 12 pairs of those. Yeah, I guess I forgotten about the wooden boots. Okay, this game is so much fun. It's almost addicting right now. I mean, as addictive as before. And also, I have seen that these things respawn much, much faster than before. So you'll see them a lot more in your caves. So the game is actually challenging right now. And this is the easiest map. You might find one of those plants. You might find one of those creepy crawlies. The zombies attacks are pretty consistent. One thing I don't like is that the attacks are kind of easy on the... I don't know, on the easy side. These ones, the bigger attacks. Also, you can recruit heroes. Actually, I don't have a lot of money, but we'll try to recruit some of them a bit later. But I think it's a little better to just, you know, buy the skill sets you need. First of all, I buy the skill books. Mage... Archer and all of warrior and all of that, and then I Might buy some of the rarer stuff. I mean, if you don't find the ships or the wool, you can always buy this one like this. Chitin armor. It's actually pretty expensive. Now, let's see, where were the heroes? I guess you can see all of the foods a little better over here. Baked potato, chargly potato. Forge fire cartridges. Yeah, I really have to play more of this so I can see what comes next. I mean, the other planets will be much harder than this, and I can assure you, the game didn't become any easier, or at least not from what I saw. Okay, so let's see, let's take a look at the heroes. So they gradually unlock as you level up. So I'm level 11 right now and I have access to these people. I think the first one you get is the Paladin. No, it actually must be Nostra Dwarfus, then the Paladin, then the Burner, maybe. Then the Anuran, which controls frogs, which is not so important. Demeter. Nonetheless, a wonderful hand. Well, I guess we can buy the Burner, the Werewolf guy, and the Paladin. Okay, then we'll only buy the Paladin and the Burner. Yeah, Steel Sword is not so hard to get. I think I have a few. Wait, you require a Burner? Oh, you need to find them? Really? I didn't think about that. So yeah, the heroes might actually be a little underpowered, but I guess in the longer maps you'll find them. So you also need to find their statues. I don't think you can build them. Yeah, so buy the recipe and find the statue. And then you can create the hero statue, which will probably bring the hero. Oh, okay, I get it. Very interesting stuff. Very, very interesting. Now, I think we did most of the boring stuff, so let's open the Pandora's box. See what I mean? These guys are everywhere right now. So you have to be a lot more careful with your light position, your torch, otherwise they'll just spawn over and over. Oh, he's very happy. Yeah, if you don't like it, you can just close it right up. So let me see, no one is sleeping, that means everyone is in a very good position. Okay, before I open that, let's craft the boots that I need. The advanced wooden boots. Yeah, I need more iron ore. I think iron ore has become much more important since these updates. I was actually mining this entire area. Well, I guess I have no choice over there. I guess that foldable staircase or whatever it's called looks very, very interesting right now. I guess you can give the quick ladder pack to... What? Oh yeah, I cannot build a hand, so to the miners. And they'll definitely make short work of all of the minerals. Yeah, so let's play a little more because I think this game has reached its full potential and from now on it can only get much better. Also very surprised that they continue working on the game. This is like Battle Brothers, except they know what they are doing. By the way, I don't have any mods installed because the mods usually make the game easier and I don't really want that since the first maps are pretty easy. I'm mostly playing with 1.5. I guess we have a little bit of time before the next monster waves arrive. Usually I go for three archers, three mages and the rest will be warriors. So yeah, probably I should make more armor packs as well. Well, but I'm a bit lazy. I guess we only have, let's see. I guess we can make two more. Now each of the warriors will have one, and I guess the next one will be also a warrior. They also improved the mages. I think the mages can freeze enemies and do some other weird stuff. It's such a better version of the game overall. You already know what the lighthouse does. I think I already showed it in the video anyway. I need so much of this iron stuff, is not even funny. Remove. How do you open it actually? I never really thought about this. Huh, it only shows dig. Okay, we'll dig around it and if that doesn't work, we'll just have to, you know, open it. I don't think it's remove. It's probably remove, really? Well, I guess that the only... Okay, let's remove it. Come on, open it. I'm really curious right now. Okay, it takes a while until it's open, maybe. Well, if I destroy it, that's that. I think this one just appeared and it actually gives you a kind of like a signal. Hey, I'm here. Do something. Treasure found. Oh, okay. I got scared for a moment. Yeah, that was actually pretty good. I guess the leather armor and upgraded versions are quite nice, but I guess I'll just have to use the wooden helmets and the wooden boots for most of the stuff I do. I mean, as usual. I mean, the wooden shoes don't look so bad. Maybe they're relaxing. The dwarves, at least. Also have the option to make the chitin ones. Well, I get the chitin set. I guess we can make the chitin helmets, which will be a little, I guess a little better, 14 armor versus 13. Okay, that's actually, okay, it's worth it. Soden boots, chitin helmets, we're on our way to a lot of great things. I guess I can play a little bit until the next invasion. Shouldn't be long now. I guess we'll have to go for that as well. Yeah, usually I kind of make everything foolproof. Armor. I try to make everything foolproof, meaning I don't really leave anything to chance. So that's why I'm actually collecting all of the stuff, because I know I'll need them later. Okay, this is probably a bigger iron vein in the whole area, so I guess I should have started with this one. Okay, I have enough mana. At some point you just have to play it a little slower so you have enough mana.
Time to my turn!
I mean, that's not doing too bad. You can probably survive this without any help. Also killed one of those bigger worms, but that's why I have a lot of chitin. No, you are a mage. Well, I guess I don't have a mage armor. Okay, I'll make some mage armor for him as well. Probably in the end game it doesn't really matter if the mage armor has mage. If the mage has mage armor. I guess only one of them is left without armor. So yeah, the silver helmets are 2, 12, well, I guess it's more or less the same, 12 and 2. That is 4, so that's definitely not worth it. I mean, yeah, I guess I'll upgrade it to, on certain maps, I'll upgrade it to the max level. Height in 20, yeah, well, I guess I have more than enough. Well, not exactly, but... should be enough. Probably I should start working on the silver pickaxes. Yeah, that's also another idea. I guess the game is going very fast as opposed to my other playthroughs. I know, this is a very, very bad setup, but I don't know. I just like it as it is. This is a very bad setup. If I... on the next map, I'll have to be more careful, a lot more careful. Usually I just make my house on the upper level and then I have this one over here. Much further away than... from my house. Wait, they're attacking the... oh, that's interesting. Oh, so actually got defeated almost. Go rest you a little. They're shooting inside my house, that was funny. Select the dwarf, go and rest. Yeah, that was kind of bad, but you know, you can always heal them. So let me see, when they say low health. By the way, I think... I found a lot of items over here, a lot of healing items, so we also have the golden apples if you really want to heal them. Maybe that would be a better idea then. So let me see the potions. Potions, I guess I can resurrect them if I really need it. Okay, looks like mostly they are okay. These guys are working on top of the house, I don't know why. He's trying to destroy the swimming pool, I mean the fish pool. I mean the fishery. What are these guys doing on the house? Yeah, I suppose I should level everything on the same field. And next gameplay I should actually make the swimming pool a lot farther away from my house. Because the loot also tends to drop inside it. That was a pretty bad attack. Also scouted a lot of this area, and as you can see, I don't know, maybe it's my imagination, but this map is a lot smaller than the other ones. Maybe it's just that I have a lot of stuff to uncover to the left. Oh, did I just see the dragon whelp over there? probably. Yeah, but at this point you should really rely more on traps because the enemies are getting a lot stronger and they are billions almost. So yeah, I guess I can outmatch them by simply having better armor and weapons. But probably on the next map I'll have to be super careful and play with the traps stock only. That's another feature I like. Probably the wooden traps are the ones you'll use the most, and then you'll have the shooting traps, shooting thingies again. Huh. The egg incubator, yeah, I guess I can anger the goblins and get the egg incubator to have a wyvern. Also, I remember seeing an imp cave or something like that. Imp's house. Yeah, I'll probably have to try to build this one as well. Silver wood. Okay, let's make an imp house and then we'll put it over here somewhere and then I'll end the video. How much water did I have? I think I have too many materials anyway and I should just rush the endgame. 91 water, that's actually quite a bit of water. Oh, you don't have a bed? Why? Well, I might have wanted to give her a bed, but I forgot. Yeah, that's probably what happened. As you can see, some of them are starting to wake up after that brutal beating and now they're returning to work as any devoted employee would be. I just want to look at them what they do. I also like my shield hall. Well, more like skull shield hall. Also, things are falling down the... We're falling down this very, very trap case, so... I guess if you just put a simple loom, what this is called over there, it will not fall through the ground anymore. A hatch, if you put a wooden hatch, it will not fall anymore. Yeah, I don't know, I think I was just too lazy to move the fishing pools. I just left them as they were. Anyway, for 44 minutes, I think I can switch up. I can upgrade my gear so much that it won't even matter, I mean, look at this. Did I miss something? Why don't I have the max amount of upgraded wood boots? Yeah, well, I guess I can just make the chitin helmets 12. That should be more than enough. Yeah, it's a very fun place. What about... Oh, it's one of those bigger structures. Okay, I guess we'll have to put it over there. I guess I have to remember this, so my house has to be a lot bigger. And maybe one more floor up top. So it should be three spaces, that's one, two, three spaces, and then the... Kind of like the step... The floor over here. This should be further away from my base. Okay, and it's all coming back to me, I remember now. Population 0 out of 5. So the Frogalisk and the old Kel will chase mice, but what will the Imp's house do? I guess it'll just be your assistant to carry the items to the stockpile so your dwarves will have a lot more free room to breathe. Predatory bush. I already discovered it. Do they only take items that are inside the shelter? They probably take only items that are inside the shelter. So I guess if you build your crafting stations over here, you will have to build Oh man, yeah. That's probably what it is. You'll probably have to build the imp houses straight over here, otherwise they'll not have enough range to collect the stuff that drops from the craftsman. Okay, that's a lot of things I have to think about and organize in the next videos. I'll probably make more videos with this map in particular because I'm so close to finishing it. I think, well, not super close, but close enough. I mean, they have a decent amount of armor at this point. Oh yeah, let's give the warriors some good helmets. Yeah, I wish you could throw away some items or just put them in some cases. Anyway, a lot of nice upgrades. Also, the bandages are pretty easy to make. I should make a few of these as well. Let's make 100. I don't remember them either. Healing 50%. Anyway, that will be useful in the future. So I guess I have a lot of things to remember and also to learn. But it's such a fun game that time just flies away. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.